So welcome to the fourth day of the event, and specifically to my talk about server-side development with Kotlin. My goal today is just to give a brief overview of using Kotlin for the server side. And I would like to share some of the information, give you some pointers to the resources or to the cases where Kotlin is used for server-side development. And I hope you will learn something and you will find the pointer to actually go and learn about it more. So Kotlin was actually created as an alternative to Java, meaning that it could be used everywhere where Java is used. So we know that Kotlin is very popular for Android development, but initially it was intended to be used as, as Java alternative, so it's pretty common to use it for server-side development as well. And this is what our theme is about today. When we talk about server-side development with Java, we always think of frameworks, about libraries, about the frameworks, and the interoperability with Java has been a priority for Kotlin since the beginning. And this was the crucial factor for Kotlin's success and for Kotlin's adoption for using it on the server side on the JVM. So when we develop something in Java, some web application in Java, we always think of frameworks, and there is a plenty of frameworks for Java development. We know Spring is the one that is basically the most popular, the undisputed leader among Java frameworks, and there is a lot of other ones. And if we talk about Spring, in Spring framework version 5, Kotlin has been the major theme for the improvements in the framework. They actually improved the core functionality, the core API in the framework to support Kotlin better. And Kotlin is supported among other languages in their Spring initializer project that can generate the empty projects from the beginning. Also, you can learn from Spring's website how to develop Spring applications with Kotlin. There is a tutorial. There is plenty of guides how to use Spring and Kotlin together, and Spring today is the most popular framework among Kotlin developers. Today we have Sebastian Deluz from VMware with the talk about the state of Kotlin support in Spring, and it will be really interesting to see what's new is coming up for Kotlin in Spring. So Spring is the most popular framework, but it's not the only framework. There is plenty of others. For instance, Vertex is very popular framework among Kotlin developers. It has been multi-language framework, like a polyglot framework from the beginning, but the new frameworks like Micronaut and Quarkus are adding Kotlin support from the beginning. And other frameworks, say Vadin and Kuba, have the extensions, the specific Kotlin extensions for Kotlin developer to use the framework more conveniently. If we go at different websites of the frameworks, for instance, Spark or Javelin, we can see that the samples in the documentation are actually duplicated side by side. You have Java and Kotlin samples side by side in their documentation. Not only we have Java frameworks that we are able to use with Kotlin, but there are frameworks that are developed with Kotlin from the ground up. So in my slide here, I have Ktor and HTTP4K, but those are not the only ones, and there's plenty. There's plenty, and we can find them on the internet. So talking about Ktor, it's actually developed by JetBrains, and it's a simplistic framework. It's designed to be lightweight, easily extendable. It's even aiming to be multi-platform. So there is a client part, which is multi-platform library today, And there are plans to make the server itself multi-platform as well. And it's taking advantage of the coroutines, of Kotlin coroutines, to enable asynchronous programming as well. To learn about Ktor and how to use it, you can actually find very nice tutorials at our play.kotlinlang.org website. In the hands-on session section, you can actually find those hands-on tutorials, and those are conveniently browsable step-by-step tutorials where you can learn about Ktor and get your feeling with the framework. So a lot of frameworks are there. There is a lot more. I couldn't list every framework in my slide, but there is a nice community repository at GitHub accessible via this link, kotlin.link. And it's a collection of different libraries, frameworks, tools, collected, maintained by the community. And there you can find pretty much any library that could be helpful for your project. Okay, this much about the frameworks. But the main question is, who actually uses Kotlin for the server side? Because if we think about Android development, Kotlin is the most popular language for developing Android applications today. And that wouldn't be that interesting if you talk, if some company is using Kotlin for Android. But it's interesting to know which companies are using Kotlin for server-side development and for services today, and what are their experience in adopting the language. So I would like to share a few cases with you that I have learned from the community. First of all, it's actually our own case. It's our own application. I couldn't get around it. JetBrains Space is the product announced last year at KotlinConf. And this is an example where Kotlin is an enabler for developer productivity, because we can share the code by using Kotlin multi-platform between different clients and services and so on. And basically, if you look at the very simplistic schema of the application, there are mobile clients, there are web clients, there is an IDE plugin, and of course there is a backend service developed with Kotlin using Ktor framework. And as I said, the enabler, didn't say it yet, but we have Hadi today, who will talk about Ktor, the framework, about the inception of the project, the current state, and the future plans. So what I wanted to say about space with Ktor and Kotlin is that the major benefit that the team acquires by using the technology is that they can share the code across clients. There's a huge amount of code shared, huge amount of common logic shared between the clients, but also between the clients and the backend. Right, and if you want to learn more about the details of the technical details of the use case, you can actually watch the presentation by Maxim Mazin from the previous KotlinConf, where he presented how it's technically implemented and what are the benefits. The other interesting use case we can find on the internet is the presentation by Martin Varga, the developer at Atlassian, about their developing Jira software, which is a cloud service, which is a cloud version of Jira, the famous Jira issue tracker, with Kotlin. And you can find it at YouTube. There are slides, of course. And the technology stack looks pretty common, actually. Spring Boot framework, they are using Kotlin. They use Project Reactor for asynchronous communication. But their journey was to take the Jira application that was the huge Java monolith and start decomposing it to be able to run it in the cloud for scalability. So they started developing new services, and they decided that they need something, they need a new language, they need a new technology, or like the updated technology stack to make the teams happier, because they wanted to work with modern tools, modern frameworks, modern programming language. And basically it comes like this. They moved from monolith to microservices. They moved from Java to Kotlin. And what they got was actually the developer happiness. And it's anecdotal evidence, as they say, but happier developer are more productive developers, right? Okay, there is another similar case actually by Expedia Group. At the previous Kotlin Conf in 2019, we had engineers by from Expedia Group sharing their experience with us about creating a Kotlin library for GraphQL. And their reasoning was that Kotlin's expressiveness, strong types, null safety, ability to have data classes was actually the enabler for them, so that they could build models, the data models that match exactly how the GraphQL schema looks like. And for them, Kotlin's Java interoperability was the key feature for adopting the language. They did not decompose the service, the legacy service before introducing Kotlin. They actually started introducing Kotlin into that existing Java application by just first introducing the data classes and then gradually converting existing Java code whenever it was reasonable. So that the video is available on our channel as well, and you can learn from there if you wish. And they have published the GraphQL library for Kotlin. There is a GitHub repository. There is documentation, presentations about it, how to use it. And since they use Spring Boot framework, they have also created a starter that conveniently configures this library in your Spring project. Another case, which is also very interesting and presents another capability of Kotlin, is Adobe Digital Experience team adopting Kotlin for high-load asynchronous services. So they published in their blog that they are switching from Java for one of the services. They are switching to Java from Java to Kotlin in order to leverage asynchronous communication by using the coroutines. The other case I want to talk about, it's not about what is the benefit here, but it's probably interesting for you if you are looking to adopt the technology, and if you are looking to adopt Kotlin, and you want to know how to do that. Springer Nature, who is known for using Kotlin, they use HTTP 4K framework for building their microservices. They have published a GitHub repository where they collected all kind of suggestions, basically about how to write the backend with Kotlin. And it's a living document. It's being edited. It's being updated. But well, this is a nice resource to look at if you are looking to adopt Kotlin for backend development. There are more cases like this. There are different banks, insurance companies, startups, databases even rewritten into Kotlin. So if you Google about that, or Google any of those titles that I have here on the slide, you will easily find those. So just to recap here, Kotlin is a nice server-side language. And at JetBrains, we are using Kotlin to actually reuse the code between multiple platforms, and it has been the enabler for teams' productivity. Atlassian uses Kotlin for Jira software, and their main reasoning was the happiness of the developers. So they are living now in the brave new world of microservices with with Kotlin. Expedia adopted Kotlin for you know, building these server-side APIs for GraphQL, and Java interoperability was the key enabler for that. Adobe is building high-load lock-free software with Kotlin and by using the coroutines. So those are very nice examples. They're basically, we have the evidence in the videos, we have the evidence in the blog posts, and I hope those companies will share more of their experience as they go. But what is common here is that all those services that we talk about here today actually are running in the cloud, right? So we cannot get around the cloud. If you haven't moved to cloud today, you probably will move there tomorrow. So what's the state of Kotlin in the cloud? There are community projects. There are different platform providers supporting Kotlin for their platforms. And here I have the example, Kotlin on Google Cloud Platform. It's a community project, pretty interesting one. It was announced spring this year. And there are plenty of examples in the GitHub repository that you can take and try to run. And if I look at those examples, I can see that some of them are actually meant to run Kotlin in a serverless environment. So serverless has experienced an immense amount of growth during the last year. And well, it's an interesting topic. And for Kotlin, there is Kotlin's framework developed actually at JetBrains. And we have Vladislav Tankov today talking about this framework. And I hope that will be interesting for you to learn about how to use Kotlin and how to simplify your development and cloud deployment specifically for serverless with Kotlin's framework. So this was my short overview of Kotlin for the server side. And I hope you will enjoy the day and you will enjoy the presentations. Thank you and have a nice Kotlin.